welcome to The Bite. I'm so excited for this episode because we are making In-N-Out animal style burgers at home. Can you believe it? I mean, let me tell you, during my whole pregnancy, that is all I wanted. All I wanted was an In-N-Out burger, and that was the one thing I couldn't get because I'm on the wrong coast. Now, if you've never been to In-N-Out, you may not understand the realness, the attachment that people feel to the burgers there. I just wanted it. I wanted it and I couldn't get it, and I had to make it, and I had to come up with the perfect recipe that was like I was there. So I did, and I'm gonna share it with you guys because it's delicious. So this is just some basic stuff. This is not everything, but we're gonna start off with some ground beef. I'm using ground sirloin. This is 10% fat. These are some diced onions, and we are going to saute these until they're nice and golden brown. And although I don't generally like to purchase this type of cheese, this is necessary for this burger. If I wanted a true In-N-Out style burger, I had to have this kind of cheese and the grilled onions. So we're gonna make the patties. This is about 1.5 pounds of meat, and it'll probably make about 4 patties. In-N-Out is known for pretty thin burgers, so I'm just gonna go in with my hands right here, but they're known for pretty thin burgers, which is kind of one of the reasons why I really, really like them. So what I'm gonna do is make it into a patty a little bit bigger than the buns that you're using, because it's gonna shrink while you're cooking it, and you want it to fit the entire patty. You don't want a bite of just all bread. So I'm making it a pretty good size, about a little bit bigger than the size of the buns that I'm gonna be using. So I'm gonna finish doing all of it, and I know it looks quite thin, but I honestly prefer very thin meat anyways. But do it to your liking. This is how I'm gonna continue doing mine. It'll end up making about 4 burgers, maybe 5, we'll see. But we'll come back when they're done. So the burgers are done. It actually made about 6 patties, and they're about 1/4 inch thick. What I forgot to mention is that I added pepper to this. I didn't add salt because we're gonna be adding a sauce that has kind of a good amount of salt to it. So just pepper to these, and then as they're grilling, on the top side, we're gonna put about 1 teaspoon of mustard, yellow mustard, on each patty. So while they're cooking, the raw side, you're gonna put the mustard, and then you're gonna flip it, obviously, to cook on the other side, and then you'll add your cheese so that it can melt and get a nice melty, you know, texture. We'll come back when they're done. Now we're gonna grill the onions for the burger. This is a very important step in the In-N-Out animal-style burger. It's technically grilled onions, but we're gonna saute them until they're nice and brown today. I have a medium pan on medium heat with a couple tablespoons of oil, and we're just gonna add my onions right in there. The oil could have heated up a little bit more, but that's all right. And we're just gonna let this cook until they are brown, translucent. They got a nice, good, sweet flavor going on, and we'll show you when we get there. So what helps me to get a nice golden color on each of the diced onions is to put them all in a nice thin layer so that they're all kind of touching the heat. Let it sit for a couple minutes, don't touch them, and then that way, when you move them, you can see that color on the onions. And that's what helps it develop. This step does take, you know, a good 7 minutes or so. And if you need to add more oil, do so. I actually did do that as well, but these are just about done. I'm gonna move them off the heat, and then I'll show you the next step. So the onions are looking good. I'm gonna remove them from the heat, but I'm gonna keep this bowl, or this pan rather. It's still got a little bit of that onion flavor in the pan, so I'm just gonna add a bit more of the oil, olive oil, spread that around. And In-N-Out is known for their crispy buns. So the insides of the buns are gonna have that nice crispy layer, not necessarily grilled, but it's just got enough crisp that you notice it. And that's what kind of distincts the In-N-Out burger from the rest. So I'm gonna let these grill, develop a nice flavor, a nice crisp, and we'll take them off, and then we'll build our burgers. The buns are done. They have developed a nice color. They're crispy, they're warmed through. That's perfect. The burgers are off the grill. My husband did a wonderful job grilling these bad boys right here. And now onto the very important step, the sauce. The sauce. the spread, you know what it is. Most burger places have their own kind of sauce, fry sauce, whatever they call it, but In-N-Out has a spread. Now, what I have here is, you know, my own little concoction of the spread. So I've got mayo, ketchup, yellow mustard, sweet relish, and a bit of salt, and some pepper. And it kind of looks like Thousand Island-ish dressing, but it sucks. It's not Thousand Island. So we're just gonna mix this all up. And we have the sauce. Alrighty, so we are ready to assemble. I'm so excited. So I'm gonna start with this one, nice and crispy. I'm gonna take, here, let's be a little sanitary. I'm gonna take my burger. I'm gonna add the grilled onions just like In-N-Out does right on top. And I mentioned that we did this on the grill. You can totally do this on a griddle. You can do it on the stove, on the pan, whatever you have. I just want to take advantage of the grilling season and get the most out of our nice new grill that we got. So, next step for this is adding the sauce to the top side of the bun. And most people at In-N-Out tend to get an extra side of the sauce because it is so good. Another thing that distinguishes In-N-Out from the rest, I must say. Maybe I'm a little biased because I'm from San Diego, but it is what it is. So I'm gonna add some lettuce. I generally like to buy romaine lettuce, but I feel like most burgers need the iceberg lettuce. I think it just sits better on the burger. I got some tomatoes, a few pickles. That's it, guys. That is it. And we have In-N-Out. In-N-Out burger. Look at this baby. Can you say delicious? Can you say West Coast? Can you say pregnancy cravings? This is where it's at. Never been to In-N-Out? You know what it is. This is not your typical burger. This is not your typical burger. You need to try this. I probably got stuff all over my face. But I'm gonna go ham on this. Wash it down with a nice cold mint lemonade. If you want the recipe, I'll link it right over here. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos. And we'll see you next time on The Bite. Let me know if you give this a try because you will be so happy you did. See you guys next time.